We're back for the Auto Line Supplier Symposium, coming to you from the floor of the Detroit Auto Show. This panel was organized by the Center for Automotive Research. Sandra McClellan, she's the Sales Development Manager for Solvay Specialty Products. You know, lightweighting is plays to your strength, and lightweighting is going to play a critical role in everything that Jay just talked about.
That's correct. You know, lightweighting is the goal. Lightweighting is the enabler to get to the 54.5 and beyond. If we can lightweight more of the vehicles, then you pull more weight out, your mile per gallon improve. So plastics and polymer composites are great at that, but you're not going to do it with them alone. It takes a multi-material approach. It takes all of the materials in the best application. A good example here in the Ford area is the Ford GT. That car has an aluminum subframe, and the body is composite body panels. That car is beautiful, aerodynamic, as you see by the racing.
Sandra, you know, we see a lot of collaboration within the plastic side of the business and a lot of collaboration on the steel side of the business. What about the two getting together and co-developing these mixed material approaches? Do you think that could be done?
Well, I think one of the things that is happening is bonding together between steel and the plastics and polymer composites and aluminum. This is a real issue, is putting these materials together. How do you combine the materials? You have to have a system that bonds them together, actually joins the multi-materials. There's a number of people working on this, including Michigan State University, who's working on a reversible bonding technique. Right now, composites are expanding, they're growing. There's new materials coming into composites. We're going from thermoset composites to investigation in thermoplastic composites, which allow different properties. They also allow better recyclability. So, you know, that's important in our marketplace. Additionally, when we talk about autonomous vehicles and other vehicle technologies that are coming down the road, plastics and polymer composites are an enabler to autonomous vehicles. Your interior is going to be different. All of a sudden, you're going to have seats that form and face each other. We're going to have a conversation, maybe a coffee table in the middle. Maybe I want my dash to be my workspace, and I want a barrier there so I don't listen to Marianne while I'm working or talking on the phone. All of this can be achieved with plastics and polymer composites on the interior of the vehicle. And I think from the safety perspective, you know, safety is a real concern with autonomous vehicles. You know, it's a concern with regular vehicles here today. When you're an impact, the impact transfers its energy to the plastic and polymer composite. One of the things that we do every year is we sponsor a program at the College for Creative Studies. What we're doing is we're training them to use plastics and polymer composites in their designs. They get so involved in this that, you know, they want to use plastics and polymer composites. They want to design, they want to move into the automotive industry. We have to educate people so that they can move forward in the automotive industry.
Hey, look, we've got to wrap this up. I want to thank all three of you. Very interesting conversation.